can go that way. Can't put it off another day. I don't care what others say. They think we don't listen anyway. Time has come today.
Spengalis, before I get into the commentary, be sure you go below the title of the video and pull up the cease and desist order that Umar Johnson received from the Pennsylvania Department of State. That is under the governor's domain. Pull up that letter. Don't get me to tell you any lies. Umar Johnson received a cease and desist order because he is operating a fraudulent charity. Before I get into this, I'm sending a huge, grand, astronomical thank you to anti-fraud warriors, to supporters, and our friends because you stayed on it. We started doing this late 2017 as far as reaching out to the Pennsylvania governor's office because Umar was running a fraudulent charity. His nonprofit status, it expired, I think it was 2017, and he continued to collect money. So we have been writing letters. We did not stop. I also want to make sure before I go any further that I give another thank you, an extra thank you to my friend Rev G, Gerald Palmer. I want to make sure everybody knows who I'm talking about because he made sure, he insisted, he wouldn't let me steer off into another conversation. He made sure I set up my library system and saved every single video that was posted on this channel. And I thank you for that because I'm like, well, I don't really need to do that because I'm not going to be making money here. Doesn't matter. Always save your materials. And he would check on me. Did you save the video? He always checked on me. And I got into the habit of doing that. So thank you, my friend, because we ended up sending several of these videos to the agencies that were investigating this. This was continuing to go on. So these people running around here with these insults that anti-Afro Spengali is a failure. Oh, she doesn't know what she's talking about. Umar has won. No, Umar never won. Umar knew what was going on. They were demanding that he produce documentation to be listed as a charity. What he did, let me tell you what Umar did. He listed these fraudulent, defunct, nonprofit status numbers with the Secretary of State, with Pennsylvania, and with Delaware. This is all mixed in together. Then you have the IRS, which is why we also told people to file complaints with the IRS. You cannot have a charity without the IRS giving you nonprofit status. It's impossible. So these issues are intertwined together, and we continue to lodge our complaints. I don't care what anybody says out there. You got to be kidding me. It's okay for somebody to run a scam for this long, claiming he's going to be opening a school, and we know good and damn well every single dime that he is spending is going into his pocket and is funding his lifestyle and his international travels, where he's bragging about frequent flyer miles and standing out in front of an abandoned bomb shelter to try to convince you that he's going to open it one day. That's okay? No, it's not okay. Allowing the nonprofit status to lapse, not giving a damn, not paying the taxes. He's not doing anything in support of a charity. And it finally caught up to him. We knew it was going to catch up to him. And we sent the videos that I recorded. We sent all kinds of documentation, and we should have did that because he's taken advantage of our people. I can't believe anybody would sit back here and say that's okay. In addition to that, he's putting your children at risk, claiming to be a mental health professional, getting money for that, and dispensing extremely dangerous advice, deadly advice, advice, if followed, that can cause irreversible harm. I worked in this field for a very long time, and I would never even consider doing what Umar Johnson does or what Dempsey does. I am not coming on here to give anybody any sort of advice when it comes to mental health issues. You know, the level of responsibility you would assume, I mean, you should be in fear of doing something like that because you can harm someone. I'll give referrals to people to check out resources in their community, but I'm not coming on here to dispense any sort of advice, to diagnose. I stay far, far away from that. That way you stay far out of trouble. But now to Umar Johnson, look what he's doing. Look how far he's going with this. This is ridiculous, people. And then he's using it as part of a charity that is not allowable. It is not legal. It is indeed criminal. So Umar Johnson must be held accountable. This is ridiculous. I don't even care about Umar Johnson's quote supporters. I never have. The only time I addressed his so-called supporters is when they came and attacked me, threatening to kill me. Other than that, I don't give a damn, because it's Umar Johnson who's going to be in serious trouble because he set up this whole gig. How many years ago now? 13 years ago? Collecting all of this money. And the vast majority of that money has been transmitted electronically. No, there aren't bagfuls and carloads of cash driving up to the abandoned bomb shelter. Yes, sure, Umar Johnson collected cash at these hyena yelps, but no, the vast majority of the money is electronically transmitted. The day has arrived. This is the first step. If he continues collecting money, he will have a civil penalty levied against him. If he refuses to pay the fine and or continues to collect money, citing this Frederick Douglass abandoned bomb shelter, never was a school, never was going to be a school, never will be a school, they're going to file criminal charges against him with the Attorney General's office. The Attorney General can decide whether or not he or she wants to get the U.S. Attorney involved. That's how this goes, people. And let me make it clear. You can read the letter. This is an investigation that took place. Umar Johnson needs to take that shit down from all social media sites where he's advertising this FDMG all over the place. He's advertising it as a charity. He's connecting it to a school. He better take it down or he is going to be in serious trouble. You all don't know what these agencies have gathered on Umar Johnson. They have access to all of the information. They have subpoena power. You don't know what they have found. Their reach is a lot longer than ours. They have subpoena powers. They can get bank records. You don't think they already did get this stuff? It's the end of the line for this fraud. He is going to be subjected to criminal charges if he doesn't comply immediately, people. The time The clock is ticking. He will be fined, and if he doesn't pay, criminal charges will be filed. That's the law of the land. These are laws that were in place long before we existed. So nobody's beating up on a black man. This black man has been messing with us, with his own people, stealing money. And because we are black, he thought he can get away with it and nothing would happen. That's exactly what Umar Johnson depended on. Umar Johnson thinks he has a right to do what he's doing. He does not have a right to do what he's doing. How in the hell can you have a right to commit a crime? This is exactly what he is doing. And to all of those people out there acting the fool right alongside Umar Johnson, whoever said anyone was looking for a battering ram or SWAT or snipers on the roof, no one ever said that. We're looking for Umar Johnson to stop what he is doing because it is illegal. And we are not going to stop insisting that he be held accountable. We never stopped. We continued to work behind the scenes. We had to pull back from Umar Johnson content because we had a thief called Let Me See Your Handcuffs who was trying to steal AFW LLC and all the content that we were generating. So you do your own damn content, which is what you should have been doing to begin with. We are resuming Umar Johnson content as soon as we take care of some business. You had to come on here and make damn sure you knew AFW friends and supporter role in this very important milestone. Just like people were upset when we came back and let everyone know that we were the ones insisting that Umar Johnson be in compliance with that block party. It was our letters. It was our calls that got Umar Johnson in compliance. I don't care about no block party. You can't have a block party. You shouldn't have a block party. I don't give a damn about a block party. I care about the safety and security of our community, and I always have. These people start coming up with all kinds of lies. The biggest lie was that I sent somebody named Dr. Kelly to go to the block party, and Dr. Kelly went and got drunk at the liquor store, and I paid him to go. What the hell are you talking about? We have a strict rule. We don't send anybody to any Umar Johnson events. It's about safety. We don't send anyone to any Umar Johnson event. Now, if Umar Johnson happens to get his ass up in court, that's another story. But Umar Johnson doesn't follow the rules. It is very dangerous. Did you see just a couple of weeks ago, he was walking around in that abandoned bomb shelter gym and all this water was all over the place? Do you know how many diseases can be caused? Just airborne, it's not safe. And Umar Johnson isn't doing anything to move the process along because he has no intention of ever opening a school. Every single time he goes live from the abandoned bomb shelter, it's because he needs a cash infusion for himself. It's about survival. There is nothing against hustling and surviving, but criminal activity over a long period of time when he never had any intention of opening a school, and you can point to that. And he just simply went and created another one and changed the name around and put one as a 501c3 and the other one's a 501c4. These are just schemes and scams. These are delay tactics, people. The time has arrived. Umar Johnson has to be brought under compliance, which we know he has no intention of doing because he's not interested in running any school. And for those of you who are not aware, that other building that he never takes you into, that building was damaged by fire when the other owners had it. And those repairs were never made. That's why Umar Johnson never takes you guys in there. He never shows anybody in those buildings because that building is like burned out, hollowed out. That will have to be probably torn down. But he's not going to tell you this. He's not going to tell you any of this because he wants to collect money from you. So we are tracking what is going to be happening with the cease and desist order. We continue to work behind the scenes doing what we do best. Umar targets a very specific population. Single mothers with school-aged children. That is his primary target. So Umar Johnson is just on the prowl. He's just preying on vulnerable people. And that's why charity regulations have to be enforced. Umar Johnson has to do what he is told. He, like everybody else, has to answer to the system. There is nobody out here that can say, I'm not going to answer to the system. I'm not going to do anything. And don't face consequences. You will eventually face consequences. May not be today, may not be tomorrow, but they will catch up to you. And they have caught up to Umar. So I want to thank everyone again for your support. Regardless of what any enemy says, it doesn't matter because we achieved a huge milestone. This is something that absolutely needs to be applauded because it means we have one less person who will be able to go around and misuse and take advantage of our people with impunity. He has consequences and these are appropriate. I'm going to make sure you all are updated. Stay tuned. You know there's more to come. Buyer beware.